Hello, and welcome to The Goddess in Art. In our program tonight, we're going to be talking with an artist whose work embodies the spirit of the goddess. My name is Starr Goode, and my guest today is Jean Edelstein. Hello, Jean.
Hello, Starr.
Jean works as a painter, as a performance artist, and in installation. Her work has been shown internationally, and she is currently represented by the Ruth Bockhoffner Gallery in Los Angeles, where she will be having a solo show in September. Jean is married and has two children, and she lives and has her studio in Venice, California. Again, welcome, Jean. Jean, a lot of your recent work shows the female figure in motion, in movement, in a dance, almost in some sort of ritual. Last year you did a series of paintings, or drawings really, that you entitled The Sacred Dance. And I know that currently you're working on some paintings that you call Ritual. And the feeling I get in all this work is a real honoring of the female spirit, and not in some abstract way, but a real physical celebration, sort of an exuberant dance of life. And I wanted to know how the goddess came to be in your work and how you became involved with her.
Well, all the time I work, it's interesting, most of the new ideas or thoughts come through the process of the work. And this, too, came through the process of my work. I had been doing a series called the Temple Series. Mm-hmm. And then at one point, we went to Santa Fe, New Mexico. And while I was there, I went to visit all the Indian sites in Arizona, Colorado, and New Mexico. And I saw a number of pictographs. And the last series, the Temple Series, was an abstract series. And while I saw the pictographs, I had a very strong emotion and feeling that it was time for me to get back to the figure. Mm-hmm. I had been a figurative artist.
And you had been working abstractly.
And I had been working abstractly for the last 13 years. Mm. And there was something that just kept propelling this idea to me. And the thought also came is that I had worked with a model, Camille Bertollet, 13 years ago, and she was a very special person. Mm-hmm. And I felt very strongly that I would love to be able to contact her, but had no way of knowing that this was possible. When I arrived home in Venice, and practically the day I arrived, mm-hmm. it was strange, I got a call from a friend who said, there's someone who wants to see you. And it was Camille.
Of course.
Bertollet. And we started, once again, working together. And we started, and it's interesting, Camille is a dancer as well, and she kept moving. We used music, and we constantly worked with movement. And this went on for about a year. After this time, I kept seeing the frescoes of the Minoan culture in Crete. It was fascinating because each time we kept working, this kept reinforcing itself.
So Camille's just movement and motion and dance just seeing her figure and was an inspiration for you, and it just somehow was like almost seeing those frescoes moving, or
it was seeing the women in the Minoan culture moving. Hmm. And because it went on for such a fairly lengthy period of time, I realized there was something there that had to be investigated, which I did. And when I did, it was a wonderful experience because I became involved with the Minoan culture and learned about their society and the fact that it was matriarchal, and also they worshiped the goddess.
Right.
This actually was my first contact with the goddess. And it became a very important one because the women in the Minoan culture had this joie de vivre, they were independent. And this is, we're talking about a culture that was 2,000 years BC.
Right.
And a very sophisticated culture, and obviously an artistic culture as well. And from then on, I realized there must be something in the worship of the goddess, which is very strong and very powerful, that I really was not acknowledged about all these years.
But somehow, when it hit you, it really hit you, and that seems so much of your work is really paying attention and to what is coming through you, mm-hmm. and that really seemed to move you. I mean, looking at the work that came from that, and you certainly honored that and paid attention to it when
right.
it came
it
your way.
Right, it moved me tremendously. And enough so that as a result, I did much more reading about the subject and was very involved with it. So, and it's really honoring the female and the energy that the female has.
And also what's so wonderful is in the dance and in the motion of the body, and again, the seeing of the body, is the female body, is a sacred thing and it's a spiritual thing. And again, you know, like not the spirit way off in the sky or something, but really in life. And that's part of the joy of life, is seeing the sacred in life right here, right now. And of course, we know in the Minoan culture, in the temples, that the women did dance in the temples, and they danced to drums, and it was part of their rituals and ceremonies, too. So you really tuned in.
Right. And it was interesting, because that's the parallel, because after that, when I started the series, I called the series The Sacred Dance, because that is the way the goddess was worshipped, not only in the Minoan cultures, but other cultures as well, where the goddess was heralded.
Now, it seemed this, all this were kind of culminated in a show you did a year ago, which you called The Spirit of the Goddess. I was wondering if you could tell us about that show.
Right. My gallery dealer, Ruth Bachofner, called me and said she wanted me to proceed with a show, with an exhibit. And what I did, immediately the thought came to me that this is really, this will be the culmination of all the work that I had been doing. And calling it The Spirit of the Goddess was important, because that's what we're working with, mm-hmm. the spirit.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore, I decided to create a temple, and a temple to the goddess and to the female, and to show what I had been feeling all along, the exuberance, the joy of life, the energy. And also, it's interesting, I realized that the Statue of Liberty was our goddess.
Oh, right, yes. Yes, she's actually in a triple Hecate. You can see her standing, you know, she's actually been depicted in the past.
Mm-hmm.
A very familiar figure holding her torch. And she is our goddess.
Right, and it was sort of a revelation to me, too, that this was so.
Well, I'd like to show our viewers and for myself to take a look at your work. We have some representations of your work, so if we could have the tape with the work, and we can see this wonderful Spirit of Goddess show that you did. Mm-hmm. All right, now here's the temple. Why don't you tell us about this, Jean?
Well, this is the temple is constructed of wood, and I wanted the color to be very luminous.
Mm-hmm.
It was important to me, because as the light changes, the color of the temple changes as well. The figures on the temple are, there's the worshiping figure, there's the dance, there's our Statue of Liberty, and also there is the mother holding the child. So that I've incorporated all facets of the female.
Now, you got a tremendous response to this, too. I think you were sort of almost surprised at what you had connected into and what a deep response you got from people.
Yes, because this was a very personal voyage. And I didn't realize how, at this point, it was touching everyone, really, I would say throughout the world. And there were many, many people that came to the gallery, which came and were so thrilled that I had finally touched upon a subject that was so important to them.
Mm. Now, this is a piece called Ritual. This is something you're currently working on.
Yes. Now, this, of course, this particular piece, once again, is the dance, which is the wonderful frenetic quality in the dance and the letting go, which I'm still continuing with. Now, this particular piece is, I'm starting now to go closer to the earth, where there's an anticipation of something happening. So there is movement, but there is a worshiping as well. And also, perhaps it'll include the birthing, which is rather a new way of me expressing it. And once again, these are females in the dance form.
This is part of the series Sacred Dance that we
discussed. Yes, this is all part of the series Sacred Dance. And I feel that this particular format is small. These are 7 by 10 inches, but size has really relatively very little to do with it. Now, once again, we have the dance.
Here's the triple goddess here.
The triple goddess.
That's so exuberant, and the spiritual quality in that, right in the sense of the matter. It's just so exhilarating, such a joy.
I feel that way. I feel there is such joy and one that it's important for us to, male and female, mm-hmm. to really participate in. Of course, the other formats that I'm working on are quite large now. They're 7 feet by 6 feet. So, yeah, this is another continuation, whether it's three figures or two figures, or here's a continuation of the sacred dance.
And again, the females in movement together and in harmony together, that feels to touch upon so much of the goddess energy of working in tandem. And of course, you work with working with Camille, who I know is more than just a model to you, and then you have a creative collaboration with her too, and so that really mm-hmm. seems to evoke the goddess spirit of relatedness and cooperation.
Right, and this particular one, painting, really is the frenzy of the dance and the letting go, the complete letting go, and I feel that it's very special for that reason.
This one I love too, because it's like a lot of motion. It's like a sequence, but it's all at once.
And also, there are many figures behind the figures.
Uh-huh.
Now, this particular series was called the Torso Series. And I did a number of these drawings. They were for paintings. They were for, once again, an exhibit at Ruth's Gallery. And I wanted to show, within the torso, now I used much brighter colors than I had used on some of the previous paintings. And but to show, once again, the spirit, which is very important, the movement, so that it's not static.
No, Jean, it is not static, certainly. Yeah, and there is such a life to these figures, there's mm-hmm. such movement.
Well, it is a celebration of form, of being alive.
And also of the power of the body, too. I mean, there is such an openness to these bodies. I mean, it's not like hovered over in the corner in some sort of sense of grief or loss, but a real power of the life coming through and the strength of the body, too.
Right. Mm. This continues the series that I had done on the torso. And I'm very pleased about these paintings because I think they do carry forth what I was trying to say. Now this last slide is of a dimensional project that I did, and they range from 1 to 6 inches. They're created on wood, and wood has a very sensual quality that I mm-hmm. love working on, and I'm very pleased about that too.
Mm. Now in this last one we saw a little more of some abstractions
yes.
too.
This was actually done 2 years ago where mm-hmm. I combined the abstraction with the figure, with the quality of the dance.
It's interesting for me about so much of your work does seem to have to do with dance and movement, and you know, if you think of again what a dance is, it is like a harmony of motion and music and sound and a connectedness of all sorts of things that does seem to reflect in your work, and somehow that it's so inspiring for you to have
well,
this motion.
It's a life-giving force. It's a very important energy, and one that I think should be expressed at all times, not only perhaps on ritual, but at all times, for all age groups.
Yeah, and that is that sense too. It's again that it isn't just something off in the corner, but the very essence of life, or the core of life, or that strength is sort of where we draw our life from.
Mm-hmm.
Now I know that this is just one aspect of Jean Edelstein, that you are also a performance artist, and again, incorporating dance and movement, that you also do paintings. You have, why don't you tell us a bit about your performance
work? It's interesting. Once again, this is a process thing.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to have Camille photograph with myself for some documentation as I worked with her. And Cy, my husband, put some black paper up on the wall and put some lights on us to do these photographs. And I felt the exhilaration and excitement when this happened. And I said, you know, as we work, there's something that's very special, and I think that this should be shown in a performance to an audience. And from there on, once an idea is planted, I continue with
it. You attend to it. You listen for it.
Exactly.
Well, let's share this with our audience. I think that they'll be very excited. We have a tape of your performance, and let's cue this up and see this, and then we'll get to see the wonderful Camille in this.
Right.
Thank you.
I would like to introduce now Jean Edelstein.
Thank you.
Well, Jean, that was so exhilarating, so powerful. It really came through us, so our viewers knew I wasn't kidding when I said there was a real joy and exuberance to your work. And the thing, one of the things that interests me so much about that is, again, the collaboration and the energy between the two of you, Camille dancing and your other dancers. Camille was the first dancer, by the way. And the, you know, that, again, the movement, but it's not only those dancers, because you're really painting with your whole body too. They're in movement and you're moving with them. And you know, when a dance really is a collaborated movement, and then you're creating from that and being inspired by that, and such a collaboration.
I feel that, first of all, it's a collaboration of the arts.
Yes.
You know, the painting, the music,
and the drums.
And the dance.
The drums really struck me, too, because
right.
they were very used in the Minoan culture in the temples.
Right. Yeah. And also, I feel that I'm part of this. So, of course, I'm not thinking, but I am working and I am moving just the way I feel that they are. Incidentally, I'd just like to mention, this is totally improvisational. The musicians had never seen us before and did not know what we were going to do.
Mm-hmm.
So I think it's an you know, I think it's exciting, the fact that when creative forces get together, we can work.
And it's all part of the process for all of you, because you're all into the spontaneity and letting sort of the spirit of the goddess come through and the spirit of creation and seeing what comes as you all work together. And there's such an intense rapport.
Mm-hmm. And it was really, the audience participates as much as we do. That's the other wonderful part about this, and feels just as strongly about this. And the tension is felt by the audience as well.
Oh yes, it is really powerful. And this backdrop here is this is a painting that you did under in a performance circumstance, right?
Right?
It's just a figure.
Mm-hmm.
And this was Camille
this was done,
too, right?
Right, right. When I first started doing the performance, that was one of my first efforts.
Mm-hmm. And again, it's interesting to me too, because you're just very much a part of it, and in the movement, and you know, just watching you move and how you just move across that mural.
Mm-hmm. It's very exciting to really be part of it.
And again, for me, it is so much of the spirit of your work, how it does, you know, the truly like the female figure in motion is really so inspiring to you. But then again, too, it was nice to see that the male dancer and you getting that energy, because I noticed that was sort of a different energy for you, too.
Mm-hmm. And I think it's important that I'm talking about, when I talk about the female, I'm talking also about the male. I mean, I feel that the harmony of both are very important, the integration of both.
Mm-hmm.
And so, and that's why I'll always include you know, the male dancers as well as the female dancers in my performances.
Mm. Yes, and again, the thing that it's so interesting of what that sense of inspiration that you get from being in that live moment and so much of your is that process of trusting and paying attention to. I know that you don't feel like necessarily in control, but that you know, you really don't know. You just let your work take you to where it's going. You know,
I feel it's very important, and I think you'll hear this from many artists, that
yeah.
There's a path that we're going, we're working towards, but we are not really totally in control of that path. We're just following, and that's how I feel my work is, you know. I'd like to also say that a lot of this, I feel very indebted to my life, because I have two wonderful children as well who are also in the arts. One is a sculptor and the other is a sculptor and painter.
Mm-hmm.
And my husband, who has been exceedingly helpful to me
mm-hmm.
at all times. I just feel that it's important to mention that there's a completeness, there's a wholeness.
And that really helps you along your path. I know, and that it's very supportive of you, and that again, you know, you're just sort of trusting and accepting what's going on and honoring that. And I know while you were getting ready to do and working on the Spirit of the Goddess show, you kept a black book, a journal, a process of your work, of, you know, your feelings and your thoughts and drawings, and I'd like you to show us some of that.
I'd love to.
This is the black book, folks.
This is a journal that I kept during the process. I felt it was important. I knew there would be a lot of things perhaps occurring
mm-hmm.
That should be recorded as a documentation.
Now you were keeping like notes of dreams and visions.
Right.
And
this is a page of the book.
We have that. Yeah.
And this has many drawings that I had done of the different goddesses that were done that are in different cultures, and the forms take many different ways, because different cultures feel the female differently. So this is one of the pages. The other page continues.
So this these were drawings page. That you were working for your temple series.
Right. These yes. This was kept during the process of doing the project. And also, it has many notes at the time that when I was very weary, when Camille would give me an acupressure session, and I would find that I would go into a trance state, which was marvelous in terms of the work that I was doing.
So this is the process of the process. I would like for you to share with us the last entry in this black book.
I'd love to. Today, I feel that my paintings are the code for me. It is a time for all women to emerge to avoid a future disaster to the planet. We have been quiet for too long.
Thank you, Jean.
Thank you, Star.
Good night.